Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 52 with Sold with Updike Pugh.
I'm Jeff Updike.
And I'm Weston Pugh, and we've got a great show today. We're going to take a look at three homes that are newer in the Oak Cliff area. Great idea.
Yeah.
Anything happening this weekend? I think Stessie was giving us the big heads up about something that was going on this weekend before the show started.
There's the Trinity River Kite Festival that's going on this weekend, which sounds like a lot of fun.
And given that the weather's been so great, this might be a great time to take the kids out. So if you're looking for something to do, we always like to pass along some of the things that we think are interesting and you might enjoy. But let's go ahead and jump in and start talking about the Oak Cliff.
Okay.
Great little area.
Yeah, it really is. And this first one's in a great little neighborhood. This is at 1877 Stevens Bluff Lane. And this is a new construction development that was built by David Weekly. It was started just a couple of years ago. And it is just right on the edge of Stevens Park Village, Stevens Park Golf Course, right next to Kessler Park. Great access to Davis. You can get into downtown through Hampton Road, going over to Fort Worth Avenue, zips right into downtown. You get to go right by the Loose Stair at Justice Center. And so if you've got any reason to stop off and see someone, it's a great location.
So this is also a great area. We've had clients that like to live in this area because they're commuting A to Arlington or even a little further into Fort Worth, and yet they're able to be on the west side of downtown. So if you're looking for an area and you want to stay, this is a great one. The other thing too, it's really eclectic over there.
It is.
Really, this is a neighborhood that is as close to Austin as it can be without being there.
You've got really great topography in the neighborhood. You're right across the street from Rosemont Elementary, which is one of the best elementary schools in Oak Cliff. You've got a good variety of that modern subdivision right there. It's just a really cool area.
So this is actually three-bedroom, two-and-a-half-bath, two-car garage. And this is brand-new construction. They've done a great job. You can see how they've done a perfect example here of combining both the living room with the kitchen. Large, large island. It just is set up for what a lot of the buyers are looking for today. This right here is the dining room.
Mm-hmm. This is the dining room that's looking toward the south. You've got kind of, I'd call them seasonal views of downtown from this, because you've got some elevation just even on the first floor of the unit. And then when the leaves fall, you can see the pretty green building downtown.
Yep. And this is also one of the things that they do typically is they give you a lot of the good appliances, large six mm-hmm. burner cooktop, cabinets that go all the way to the top. Everything that we're looking for that kind of makes a show place. And again, we're going to see how it does transition from that living room into the kitchen. And what we'll also notice is that this wall of windows are actually what overlook a very mm-hmm. large deck on the side.
Yeah. And this is it's the non-destructible, Trex. Thank you. Trex decking out there. And this being an end unit, you've still got, you don't feel like you're just right next door to somebody. It's gives you some great outdoor space. And then from when you come back in from that, you get to go upstairs and into the master bedroom, which is what we're looking at here. Trade ceilings on it. I think these, even in the non-trade portion, these are
11 foot. They are high.
They really are. And which makes those rooms seem really gigantic. That's a king size bed in there, and you've still got all that extra room. So this leads into the master bathroom. It has a separate tub, separate shower. This owner did the upgrade where you have the seamless glass in the shower, and then you also have the one level floor as you walk into the shower rather than having to step over the curb.
Yep. And one of the things that I love about what the David Weekly has done is they've actually pulled the concept of having a master bathroom that then opens up to the utility room. So that you can see there in the left hand of the picture, there is the washer, mm-hmm. and that actually also then opens up to the hallway. So it's really, really one of the things that we've seen in the last 5 years, and it's really come around really well done. This right here is going to be the second floor master. Again, second floor living room, and all of the bedrooms are going to be on the second floor. And the final picture that we're going to show you today is going to be the office, and the office is actually on the third floor, almost like a like a crow's nest.
Yeah.
Has its own HVA system. And from here, you definitely have some amazing views of downtown.
You really do. And this is the, this in the original construction was an outdoor area that this owner incorporates in and uses for office space. So it's really great use of that space.
So this is going to be a 3-bedroom, 2.5-bath, 2-car garage. It's 3,110 square feet, built in 2016, low HOAs offered at $665, which is $213.83 a square foot.
Yes, and we want to say thank you to Hewitt and Hadgood for letting us talk about their listing today.
Yep, great listing. We're going to move over and stay at in the Cliff again, like we talked about. And this is 905 North Montclair Avenue. And again, what we're going to be talking about is an area of Dallas or the Cliff that is really walkable. Mm-hmm. You wouldn't expect this to be so walkable in the neighborhood, but you've got topography, there's actually some trails, and I also believe that the clubhouse for the Stevens Park Golf Course is probably 300 yards away from this house.
Yeah, this is right there at the point where Montclair, Kings Road, that all kind of come together, and there's a cluster of little historic and conservation districts right there that provide a real community feel mm-hmm. for these houses. This one is has really great walk up. I mean, it feels like you're in the country as you walk up to this one. On a good sized lot, good separation, but there's been a lot of improvements made to this one that just make it a showstopper.
So this one was built in 2007. It's a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, and it is that one story that is so popular today. The open concept in this one is flanked with built-in media cabinet and the cabinets on the mm-hmm. side. The low impact of the floors is cement. So these are things that actually add to the ENERGY STAR rating of this home. I think one of the things that you and I noticed when we went in there is even as a 2007 build, this thing was really nice and cool in there.
Oh,
it
yeah.
was, given that it was 110 degrees, it felt like mm-hmm. outside, it really was able to maintain the temperature as well.
Yeah, and this is kind of a new rendition of that open floor plan right. that everybody is really drawn to, where you have the kitchen that is tucked a bit away to the side, but it's got the open bar with seating where mm-hmm. if you're having people over for cocktails or dinner, you've got plenty of space for everybody to kind of sit down and be entertained while you know the host is getting ready.
So the great thing we liked about this one is that there's A, enough cabinets, B, enough countertop mm-hmm. space, and that the width of the kitchen is really great.
Yeah.
So a lot of times they make the kitchens more galley and they just don't make sense. Last but least is that this does have a really cool little eat-in area that has built-in seating mm-hmm. and the little table that's also made out of metal. One of the things that we liked was that off of the kitchen, off of the master, there was also outdoor opening to mm-hmm. the backyard. So a lot of times you only get one actual way to get there. This one actually gave you two, which we thought was really great. Master here is seen. Again, large bed, plenty of room for your
nightstand storage. Yeah, and you've got the access to the outside yep. right there with some really great entertainment space. The master bath in this has also been done really nicely. Solid surface countertops there, the elevated bowl type sinks, walk-in shower with the seamless glass shower doors. Just really nicely done.
One of the things too that this one has is it has bedroom 2 that we see here, and the texture on the walls doesn't really come through, but we believe that this was actually what would be a wood flooring type product.
Mm-hmm.
It looked really great.
The grain was
really more pronounced, and it would be probably rough on the foot, but it was really great when mm-hmm. it was on the wall. The bedroom 3, which is also used as an office, is at the front of the house. Again, we're continuing with the cement floors. Really a light, bright, high-ceilinged house.
Yep, it was really nice. And I think we've got one last shot here that'll show the outdoor area on the rear of the house. That's right off of the master bedroom. Also has access off of the dining room. And it's xeriscape landscaping
yeah.
Pretty much all the way around this house. So you've got your low impact footprint even through that part of it.
I think that owning this home would be super easy, and it would still have lots of color throughout the year, fall and spring.
Yep.
So if this is something that you're interested in, this one is going to be...
it's a three-bedroom, two-bath. It's a little under 1,700 square feet, built in 2007. And 905 North Montclair is priced at $450,000. That brings it in about $268 a square foot.
And we want to say thank you to Melissa O'Brien. This is a wonderful house, and we know that it'll be moving quickly.
Yep.
Next on the list. This one was this was a surprise house.
Mm-hmm.
This one did not expect what we saw. The pictures are amazing, as you're going to see. But 339 West Brooklyn Avenue was a surprise.
Mm-hmm.
This is in the area of Oak Cliff.
Mm-hmm. And it's really, the neighborhood is called Dallas Land and Loan.
Yes,
and there are three subdivisions there that were made, Dallas Land and Loan 1, 2, and 3. And this was an area that was platted back in the 1800s. John Marsalis and a business partner bought 2,000 acres of land right there on the Trinity River, and developed it into these big lots where they started building all these Queen Anne Victorian style homes.
Interesting. So what we have over here in this neighborhood is a three bedroom, three and a half bath, two story. And I have to say that this house, it sits so well on the lot. Mm-hmm. So they've done such an amazing job of really giving you a really large front porch and a really large walk up. The curb appeal is amazing. Once this thing fills in, you're really going to get a bang for the buck. Adirondack chairs on this would be easy mm-hmm. add to that as well.
Yeah, and it's that great robin's egg blue that mm-hmm. you know, this style of home and this era of home really deserves.
Yep, and one of the things that they've done is they've taken the look of the bungalow, but then they've taken and made it transition into a modern home. So the way that the living room flows to the dining room, mm-hmm. and flows over into the kitchen, the way that it becomes one space so that it can flex as you need it. They also paid attention to today's trends as far as light fixtures, whether they were pendant mm-hmm. or the dining chandelier. They really took and went and made them unique, and they kind of all begin to work together. You'll see where you have the cabinets that go all the way to the top. You've got the six burner, the double oven, built-in microwave. It all is mm-hmm. on point in this house.
Yeah, and it's I think all of it is really custom cabinet work because
built on site, I bet.
Yeah, these rooms, they're, you know, again, they've got 11 to 12 foot ceilings in them, and you know, you can't buy off the shelf stuff that's going to hug the ceiling the way that this does. Solid surface countertops in the kitchen, as you mentioned, and then we transition from there back into the front room, which is the office area. And they've done an amazing job with these wood floors there, where the borders up against the walls are done differently than the center of the floor. So you can see it right here in these. You've got this really thin edging of a lighter wood around the edge, and it's kind of a unique design point. Right. That we don't see, but really was appealing.
It's a go-to that the developer is actually showing off their ability. One of the things that we noticed about this house is that the bedrooms were so enormous. Master's on the first floor behind the kitchen. This is an actual example of what is an ensuite or mm-hmm. a second master at the back of the house. And that is a balcony that is off of that mm-hmm. actually overlooks a backyard. Secondary bedroom, as Jeff was talking about earlier with the flooring, also is oversized.
Mm-hmm.
And that oversized continues into this utility room. What a bonus on this one.
Yeah, and again, you know, a lot of utility rooms, even the ones that are this size, they've got that one small section of countertop area mm-hmm. in the sink. This one's got one on the other side of it and the cabinets to go with it. I mean, you know, it's kind of your cross between having your utility room and your gift wrapping room and, you know,
and a mud room.
Yeah.
And where your pet stays when you're not home.
That's exactly right.
So the backyard, you continue. It's a low impact, as was the first house with the crushed granite. But what this one has is it has a really large covered patio with that two-story balcony above it.
Yep.
This is an enormous seated area that's covered. Really a great extra. One of the houses that we're just seeing so many things come about is that low maintenance. Mm-hmm. And again, not a lot of grass on this one in the front yard, so you're not spending it weekly, and it doesn't cost them a lot to keep it going.
Yeah. So 339 West Brooklyn Avenue, 3-bedroom, 3.5-bath, a little over 3,000 square feet, brand new construction, priced at $775, brings it in about $252 a square foot, and another really great value. And we'd like to say thank you to Susan Melnick for letting us talk about her home today.
Great cross-section of homes, and it's interesting because 10 years ago, it would have been hard for us to have had three homes that were new construction to talk about. And I know 2007 is not like typically considered new, but it's
newer.
Newer
than a lot of Oak Cliff.
Absolutely. So it's really exciting to see how things are coming in. It's just really revitalized that neighborhood and just is going so strong.
Yep. So if there's any of these houses that you'd like to see, certainly reach out to us, give us a call. We'll be happy to meet up with you and let you take a look at them.
Perfect.
So we have a interesting second segment today.
We have a great second segment. So we have actually had a master plumber, Josh King, is going to be on the show today, and he's going to talk with us and tell us a little bit about what to do to protect your investment and what are some of the things that he, as a master plumber, does to take care of his property. And I thought it would be great. So thank you so much, Josh, for coming on, man.
Thanks,
it is great. We've had
you
on the books for probably, I think, 60 days. So yeah,
sounds about right.
We're glad that we were able to connect. We were able to sit down with Josh the other day and kind of talk about what the show was going to be. Mm-hmm. And it always helps us get a better understanding of what we're going to bring to you. And we always want to share with buyers and sellers some of the things that they can be conscientious of. And one of the things that we wanted to talk about are there's really some key infrastructure things that homeowners should know about in case of an emergency.
Sure.
And things that they should have. So start off by telling us what those elements are.
Okay, sure. There's three main systems in your house. There's the sewer, the water, and the gas. You're always gonna wanna know where your main water shutoff is. Very important. It's usually gonna be in the meter.
Okay.
It's the easiest place to shut the water off to the house. Some houses have a shutoff up close to the house, but the easiest place to find it is the meter. I brought some props.
Love props.
Yeah. So this is a water shutoff key.
Okay.
You can find them at any Home Depot, hardware store, Lowe's, whatever. Always keep one of these handy.
Okay.
Okay. To get into that meter box, some lids are going to have a lock on them. This is a key to unlock that.
Okay.
Again, you can find it at any hardware store, any Home Depot, Lowe's. Open the lid, turn this bad boy, turn the water off.
That's so important to know because you'd be surprised at how many people don't know what to do and they have just the biggest panic.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. If you have a leak, the last thing you want to do is wait for somebody to show up to your house to turn the water off.
Absolutely. And then you also mentioned about the gas. So it's important to also know where the gas cutoff is.
Absolutely. So houses that have gas are always going to have a gas meter somewhere on the property. If a house has an alley, sometimes they'll be in the alley where you may not be visible very well.
Right.
Walk your property, find out where your gas meter is. Easiest way to shut that meter off, there's going to be a valve on there. Big, giant crescent wrench. The bigger, the better. Easier it is to turn off. If you smell gas in your house, shut the gas off. If you can't find the meter, obviously call Atmos. But all Atmos is going to do is come shut the gas off, tell you to call a plumber.
Interesting. Yeah. So that kind of is an interesting way that we don't actually have to, if we smell gas, we don't have to call Atmos first thing.
Right. Right.
Okay, that's kind of news to us. Like, I would have thought the first thing I had to do was pick up the phone and call Atmos.
Right, so the first thing, if you know where that gas meter is, shut that valve off. That's going to keep you safe.
Right.
And then call a plumber.
Excellent.
And come out. Plumbers can do all the testing, find the leak, repair it, get your gas turned back on, minimal downtime.
Excellent. Well, one of the other things, too, that I thought was really interesting is how we talk about when we go on vacation, we know how to turn off our HVAC.
Sure,
we know how to let the neighbor know to pick up the mail. But you do other things to get ready. And I think that if a master plumber is going to do it, that probably the rest of us should think about it as well, because you've been around.
Sure. Yeah. So one of the things you never want to have happen is you're on vacation. We had some friends that were out of the country, got a phone call from their neighbor. Hey guys, you have water running out of your house down your driveway.
Nobody wants that call.
Nobody wants that call. So what I do before I go on vacation, summertime, wintertime, go out there, turn that meter off like we talked about.
So you go out to the street with your big key, open it up, and turn it off.
Turn the water off, go in there, open a faucet, kind of relieves the pressure a little bit, and then you can leave.
So you actually turn the water off and then you kind of drain out what water's in line, but just open
a faucet
out.
And you'll kind of hear it, you know, relieve the pressure.
Should you flush the toilet too, or is that
overkill? That's a good idea. Okay. Yeah. Never overkill for sure. Yep.
And you also mentioned you have a tankless hot water heater.
Correct.
And you actually do something to your tankless hot water heater.
Yeah, sure. So most tankless water heaters have a control panel. I just turn the power off.
Okay.
Tank top water heaters have a control valve on the front. You can turn that down to the lowest setting. Some will actually say vacation mode.
Really?
And it just it keeps it where it's just the pilot lit. You're not paying to heat that water over and over. Yep.
Excellent. These are all important things that I think that we should know, because we never want to have experience. I know that when I go on vacation, last thing I want to be doing is worrying about water back home. So
absolutely,
these are great things. We also talked about maintenance and how important it is with water, is that what starts off as a little drip can actually become a really big problem. And so what are some of the things that homeowners should look for, maybe replace, and then eventually call you to have help?
Sure. So easiest thing you can do, look under your cabinets, under every sink. If you don't see a connection like this, flexible supply connector, have it replaced.
Really?
If you have a rigid type, if you have a copper type, just replace it with these. They're cheap, $6-7 a piece.
Okay.
And, or if you do have these type and you see any sort of corrosion anywhere on this, have it replaced. These will rupture if they're corroded and get rusted.
So again, you need the key, because you're going to turn the water off before you do this.
And absolutely.
You're going to drain your lines and then you replace these things, or you call Jay and Josh takes care of it.
Yeah.
One of the other things that we brought up was a toilet. We've all been on a toilet. It's precarious at best, and it's the toilet that rocks. Tell us a little bit about that, because that is that when you were talking about this, I was like, that sounds terrible.
Yeah. So rocking toilets are a common thing. Most people don't call to have them repaired until there's water coming out. Okay, but what happens under there is when that thing is rocking, the wax seal that keeps the water inside is failing.
It's failing.
So what happens when you flush that toilet? A little bit of water escapes, starts to rust in the rings, the bolts. That's when the repairs get really costly.
So that's when we've gone from just having a little rock to now we have a lot more to replace, and it has changed it to a whole different set of parameters.
Right.
Interesting.
Yep. Correct.
So this is a interesting one, because I feel like we have a lot of people that think that this is possible. Yep. So I'm going to ask you a true or false. True or false, a handyman is okay to install gas logs in your fireplace or decorative fireplace gas.
Sure. So I will tell you, in the state of Texas, it is illegal for anyone to contract any sort of plumbing work without being licensed.
Licensed.
Period. End of story.
So that is really important, because I see so many times when people are like, oh, I can do that, or my handyman can do that. You really need to be careful about that, because whether they're using the right materials, whether they've attached the fittings properly.
Correct.
There's some really key things, and I probably am more sensitive to others to fire, giving some of the things that I've experienced.
Yes.
I would definitely stop anyone who thought that they could do it that was not licensed.
Yes. All licensed plumbers go through rigorous training to know how to install gas connections properly.
Good. Okay. Well, another true or false that we've got. We all know that we want to have a plumber take a look at some of the older homes and the plumbing lines that are in them. Mm-hmm. True or false, is it important for a homeowner to actually have a plumber come out and look at a new home construction?
Absolutely. You'd be surprised how many sewer line repairs we do on new homes. What happens is that line is all tested by the city before the slab's poured.
Right.
After the slab's poured, there's tractors rolling around, skid steers, trucks. They can run over some of the clean outs and pipes and crack that underground. No one ever knows about it until roots start growing in.
Yeah. And then it's a problem when you go to resell it and they have a line scope.
Absolutely.
And then you have to make the repairs.
Correct. Yeah. Yeah. And in older homes, it's the cast iron, the Orangeburg, the clay.
Right.
That can be very costly.
That
we all know about.
Right.
But nobody thinks, oh, this is, you know, newer home, PVC, we're good to go. Always have it scoped.
I am a firm believer in that. So you've heard it from the master plumber that said it. One of the last things that we're going to talk about, and it's just kind of in passing, one of the reasons why we decided to bring invited Josh onto the show was because earlier this year on Facebook, you made a post that got our attention. And you were talking about some legislation that passed that was actually problematic for homeowners and was a safety issue. Tell
Absolutely,
us a yeah. little bit about that and how that got handled.
Yeah, so there was a bill that was up for vote in this latest session. The bill was to abolish the state plumbing board. So what that meant was that any handyman could come in, you know, do work on your gas, do work on your water lines, any sort of thing like that. Guys who aren't trained to detect cross connections, to detect, you know, any sort of dangerous situation like that. So we the plumbers got together. We fought that.
Right.
That the plumbing board got reinstated. So that's a great thing.
Yes.
So there's just so many things when you go to a medical office that medical gas that you mm-hmm. get hooked up. The plumbers install that. Specially licensed plumbers install that.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, so it's you don't want guys who aren't trained.
So it could be something that could affect all sorts of industries,
absolutely,
not just homeowners.
Absolutely.
So that was one of the reasons why we were so key on having you on. Josh has also helped us before with different projects. So again, we just knew that what we were getting was going to be the truth. So we want to say thank you so much to Josh for coming on the show. It's been great.
Yeah,
we appreciate it.
My pleasure. Always great hanging out with friends.
We'll see you around next time.
See you.
Well, that was Josh. He was on the show. If there's anything that you saw on this or had questions, please let us know. We would be happy to visit with you about that and get some feedback.
Yep.
Well, good deal. That is, we are 3 minutes early, so I think we did a good job with today's show.
Yeah, we wrapped it up in time. We're usually like a minute or two over, and it's...
We're paying it back.
Right. A minute at a time.
A minute at a time.
Well, thank you all very much for tuning in today. We've really enjoyed spending time with you. Visit our Facebook page. You can go out there and like that. Watch episodes of the show. Visit our Instagram account. There are pictures of the homes that we have for sale out there. Lots of basic information that we try to provide, tips and tricks. Go to updikepugh.com. It's our website where there's a lot of detailed information that you can have. You can also set up searches for homes there. Last of all, homeprice.fyi. If you've got a piece of property you want to get a value on, go out there, put the address in, a couple of other pieces of info, and you will instantly have a value to that property. Last of all, reach out to us by phone or text 214-377-2223. And we thank you very much for tuning in today.
And remember, we want to be your realtors for life.